Make way for the hot ones. You're just ruining it for everybody. No, that's not what I think you're saying, it's what I'm actually saying to Rob.
Exactly, he's talking to me. It's private conversation.
Get off! Robbie, no one is taking this stage until this musical ensemble gets this crowd to a fever pitch. I leave it to you, sir.
Are you ready?
Episode that airs this week. what you should be.
To all youths who didn't raise your hand, got my eyes on you.
We got a cool one happening this week. How many of you, were there any, I know there were a few people that actually attended Haley Fest this past week. Okay, very few of you. They got a cool sneak preview of the episode, and it was, Jared and I got to sneak in and watch it with, a few of us got to sneak in and watch it with an audience that was maybe a little larger than this crowd here. Yeah, and it was awesome. It was certainly an experience that we had not had.
I actually found myself laughing at it, legitimately, like laughing at it like a TV show as opposed to...
Well, you also have to understand, it was the first time we'd seen it too, and we'd only seen renderings of the animation, so we had not seen the animation put to life with our voices behind it and that whole thing, so... And this was stuff that we recorded over a year ago. It's taken this long to... That's how long it takes for the animation, the whole process, so... It was pretty awesome. Experience and
so for those who didn't see it, we're excited for you to see it on Thursday.
Yeah.
All right, without further ado, or I don't.
Ouch! I thought it was funny.
Thank you. See?
One did.
It was a general quiet consensus. Hi.
Hi there. My name is Charity, and my mom Debbie's on the phone. She couldn't be here, so can you say hi, Debbie?
Hi, Debbie.
Hi, Debbie.
Okay, I'll call you back, Mom. I love you. Bye.
Debbie's like, ooh!
So my question is, on the episode that you had Lucille Dean, Jensen, was Jeffrey Dean Morgan...
I thought she was describing, you know, they say like Demon Dean, Soul Scan. Lucille Dean? Who is Lucille?
Yeah, we haven't seen that character yet. It's,
that's next week's episode.
Yeah, it's pretty flavorful.
Was Jeffrey Dean Morgan aware of that scene, or did you just surprise him by letting him watch the scene on his own? And if he was aware or wasn't, what was his reaction to it?
He was not aware. I don't think he was, because it was actually written in the script. It wasn't just some like crazy thing we cooked up on set, which is normally what those things are. So it was done just kind of very nonchalantly. A little tip of the hat to what they do over there, and I'm not even sure if he saw it or was aware of it, so I'd imagine his reaction would be like, cool. Something like that.
Great. All right, thanks, you guys. Take care.
Thanks, bye.
Thank you.
Bye, Sherry. Bye, baby.
Hi. So I have a question. You guys have been working on the show for so long. Besides each other...
Hey, take it easy.
You guys have been working on the show for so long. Yes, thank you.
Besides each other, who is the closest to you guys, like, family-wise, within the cast and crew?
I'm pretty close to this, the chick who played Ruby. Real close. Is everybody 18? No. I think for me it's pretty easy. Yeah, I think I'm pretty close to Ruby.
Well, Sister Joe. Wives excluded?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. I think, well, let's see. There's there's certainly a family that exists with this cast and crew, and you know, it's we have been very fortunate to have situations like this where we get to kind of all reconnect every few weeks and hang out and get to share this common love for a show. Bizarro Santa Claus here. You're a few months early. Security. It would be hard to pick. We've got a pretty solid group of people here, and I think one of the reasons why we continue to not only do the show but to do these kinds of shows is because of the people that we have in our camp, and it's a pretty cool place to be. So, I mean, you run down the list of these guys: Misha, Ruth, Rob, Rich, and all of the above, Marks, and Cliff. Well, yeah, there was a guy named Cliff. I don't know. I don't think he's here today. But again, it's a pretty awesome group to be a part of, and it keeps growing, which is the coolest thing on the planet. So.
We had it's no secret, I guess, that Spade directed an episode. So he was on set, and you know, cut, and he comes in, he said the lineup, and he says to me, he's like, "Okay, Sam. And I was like, "Sam?" I was like, "Spade, we stopped the trains in Europe together. And you're calling me Sam?" Like, Jared is my name. Kind of got a funny laugh at that, but to kind of echo Ackle's sentiment, we've been lucky to grow so close with a big old gang of Supernatural cast and crew, extended cast and crew, so I'm just very grateful. Hopefully all those friends too.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hi. So what's your guys' best prank? Either on set or off set that you guys have pulled either together or separate? Like, what's your best prank?
I think the 2 weeks that Misha was directing an episode, there were a lot of fun little things. I think just the fear that he lived in. Abject terror, I think is what it's called, was enough to put a feather in our cap. I'm gonna go with that. I think this was fun to mess with Misha.
Yeah, I was talking about this in my meet and greet. The pranks, I guess, that you would call them, they're not like very heavily thought out or mapped out, right? Like some pranks would be. I said it's more of just a constant array of shenanigans that happens, and if we can mess with somebody. Then we do it. So it's not really pranking. It's just this. It's just living. It's just life. I'm constantly screwing with the camera so that it messes up the shot. He's constantly fondling somebody underneath the camera frame. We'll rearrange things. A lot of times we just change the words during our off-camera to where it does nothing. I did this to Spade, I think on Friday. So he comes in, he says his line, and I'm supposed to give a response. And on his coverage, I changed the response to be something probably inappropriate. So there's one of two things that happens. Either he breaks and laughs, and the take is ruined, and my job is complete. Or he holds it together and continues with the scene, but then it festers. So it's like rolling a grenade into his mind. Because I've said it, and now he can't forget it, but now he's just trying to keep a straight face throughout the rest of the take. So then the take's blown anyway, because he's not even thinking about his stuff. It's fantastic, and I enjoy it.
We enjoy it too, so.
Well, thank you.
Um,
I know you guys probably become real close to your fellow cast members. Out of all the deaths that there's been, have you guys taken any of them worse than others, knowing that you won't be able to work with them anymore? And
well, the wonderful thing about Supernatural is we really don't know that we won't work with them anymore.
I'd say early on, we probably took some deaths pretty hard, you know? Like, it was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe they killed that character off. Like, I love that character. I also love the person that plays it. But through the years, we've become, you know, we'll get all upset about losing someone, and then all of a sudden, it's like, guess who's coming back? So I feel like now we're a little gun-shy and getting really emotional about anybody that dies, because we're like, well, listen, I'm not saying goodbye, okay? Because I'm just going to say, I'll probably see you later. And if I don't, then I'll get sad, but I'll have forgotten about you anyway, it doesn't matter. It's a great defense mechanism.
I think that's pretty hard. I think it was pretty difficult the first time I ever read about Sam Winchester's death. I was like, oh man, I like this show. Got a good to do. And then luckily I got a script for the next episode. I was like, oh, I'm back. It's good.
I felt like that the first 60 times I read these. And I finally got over it.
That having been said, I did take Bobby's death. It was pretty bad. It was a great episode. It was a proper send-off. And here's the reason. And this, we didn't know that there'd be a season 13 in an apocalypse world, and a season 12 where we run into like a bizarro Bobby. So what the wonderful but tragic thing about when Bobby died is it was such a proper send-off. We weren't in the episode a whole lot. You know, it was a lot of him and Rufus. And so it felt like, man, I know it's Supernatural, he can come back, but that was such a proper send-off for such a beloved character that it would kind of be a shame if next episode he was like, here I am, I'm better. Like, oh, come on. It was such a nice tribute to such a beloved character. But I think, luckily, with Apocalypse World, we were able to bring him back properly, but not really bring him back, or bring a version of him back. So yeah, let's go Bobby Charlie. Yeah. Now we're all sad.
I mean, Ruby. Probably will end without.
Yeah. It's been a song wrong. Thank you for your question. Hi.
Hi.